Hey guys, Lucas here and welcome to Last Week in Rocket Launches, where I give you a quick overview about all major rocket launches to space and talk about what they carried. Let's go! We begin our journey at Florida in the USA because that's where both rockets launched from, just a few days apart. The first rocket was a Falcon 9 for SpaceX, carrying the next batch of Starlink satellites. The other rocket, what a surprise, is another Falcon 9 for SpaceX, also launching Starlink satellites. Yes, two SpaceX rockets in 1 week carrying the same payload. This will become much more common as SpaceX plans to launch more than 10,000 satellites in the next few years. The rockets lifted off on October 18th and 24th respectively, and the latter was actually SpaceX's 100th successful mission thus far. Congratulations on that. As usual by now, both rockets were pushed by their reusable booster stage, which is going to land on a drone ship out in the ocean. Following the coast to the northeast, SpaceX aims for a 53 degrees inclined orbit, which is fairly similar to the ISS one. However, Starlink has multiple such orbital planes, so they don't all sit in one long train. Speaking of it, I recently tried to look up some footage online and found out that most Starlink satellite trains on YouTube are actually fake. Yup, people upload fake Starlink trains for clicks. Who would have thought? That's really sad if you ask me, because the real ones get buried. Reality, of course, looks much less spectacular. I also suspect these fake Starlink trains are partly the reason why so many people get upset about them. Anyways, the satellites will actually distribute out so that in the end you'll only have one satellite overhead most of the time. I know many astronomers are worried about the light pollution caused by that, but one positive note is that Starlink doesn't shine by itself. They actually need the sun to reflect off of them, so they will mostly only be visible shortly after sunset or just before sunrise in the morning. Still, amateur radio astronomy is doomed, I guess, unless they find a way to filter out Starlink efficiently. I recently had a short discussion on Reddit with such a radio astronomer, and he was actually really worried about the planned 4G network on the moon. Apparently, one 4G device on the moon can cause more radio noise here on Earth than what they try to listen to coming from space. Makes sense, because these things are sometimes thousands of light years away, if not millions, when talking about other galaxies. They could in theory solve communication on the moon using laser beams, but I'm not sure if they are really willing to do that. Back at Falcon, both boosters landed on the drone ships out in the ocean successfully. They get tucked back to the coast and are then prepared for the next launches in the following months. I think the record so far is at 6 reuses, and Elon indicated the possibility for up to 100, though given some repairs on the engines. That's a unique advantage for SpaceX in that their boosters got paid for by customers and they essentially reused them for free, where other satellite constellation operators had to buy expensive rocket flights every single time. That's why the only really competitive satellite constellation at the horizon is Amazon's. They will launch on their own partially reusable New Glenn rocket. Like Falcon 9, New Glenn will land on a ship but still carry an expendable upper stage. Future will tell how quickly SpaceX can make Starship fly, which they currently develop in Boca Chica. They really needed that one online ASAP, because New Glenn will be able to launch quite a few more satellites in a single launch than Falcon. Some people don't take this seriously yet, but Microsoft and SpaceX recently announced a partnership between Starlink and their Azure server farms. Microsoft takes Amazon's servers very seriously and they will soon get their own satellite constellation. They really don't want to fall behind that. Bundled with all Amazon otherwise has to offer in terms of services, this just has to be taken seriously. Starlink itself has no services thus far. They rely on people just wanting the internet. Amazon, on the other hand, could bundle a free Amazon Prime subscription with all their movies and free shipping to their satellite internet. They are currently investing big, especially in India, which are 1.4 billion potential customers waiting. And at least all Indians I know personally really like to watch movies. The largest YouTube channel, which passed PewDiePie not so long ago, is not by accident the Indian T-Series. So I think Amazon's goal here is clear. They want to connect India with high-speed internet and they will use their services to promote it. Starlink will really need a big head start to compete with this. But I don't want to make this sound too negatively. For us customers, this is a dream come true. Two operators fighting over us, and not just a monopoly we have to suck up. But what do you think? Can Starlink really get in trouble, or do you think Blue Origin won't reach their goals anytime soon? Let me know in the comments. In the end, a big thank you to all my supporters and YouTube members. You helped make this possible. Also a big thank you and shout out to the guys from the KSRSS mod for KSP I used in this video. It brings the real world into KSP at the same scale so that you can fly with your regular rockets. They are working on the next big update to even support the latest version. But there is more, and the full list of all mods I used is below. Okay, that shall be it for this week, and I hope to see you in the next one if you like. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.